today our first task will be about the steps on creating or building the numerical the static model. So here we say the data type for the data type to create a reservoir model. So we have different kind of data. We have different kind of data which are supposed to be used in order to create or to create the model, static model. For the first data type which is required to be used in order to create a static model, this is called a well header data. So as you know, like we have wells which are being drilled in our basin or in our area, in our exploration area or developed field. So well header is one of the very important data which is required. Like it's a key data which is required. We are going to build a static model in the subsurface. We need to have this kind of well data. So what is required? What is within the well head data? First, well head data, it complies of location. So you need to have the coordinate of that well. You can see here in this demonstrated video, like we have, okay, let me show you here. We have this one, we have X, Y. So this is just to show us like we are having the coordinate, we know exactly where our well is. So this kind of data, we call them as well header data. And then we need to have something called KB, kale bush. So this is very important, but something to know is like once KB is zero, once the value of KB is zero, it means that kind of wells or that kind of wells are being drilled in offshore environment, like it is on offshore. So if it's offshore, then we are not expecting to have the value of KB. So the value of KB would be zero. But if it's onshore, then we would have different kind of values of KB. Also, we will have a top depth and bottom depth. But some of them, they have measured depths. Sometimes in some of the data, you may find we have measured depth and maybe bottom depth. It depends with the data type you are having. But this kind of data is the one we call them as well header information. So the information of your well, like from the top to the bottom. So all the information about the location, the Kelly Bush KB, the elevation, like elevation KB, sometimes it depends on the elevation. It's like an elevation. So it depends on the location of the well. So this is the first data you need to have when you want to create a static reservoir model. And the second one, from the data which are required for this well header data, all of them we have complies. Like let me show you something like for the well head data, it's within the well data. Like when building a static reservoir model, the other data which are required in the format, this format are just because they depend this kind of format. They depend on the type of the software you're using. So for example, for this one, well data, we have well header. There is a form, this format will help you when we want to import this kind of data into our software. But also from well data, also there is another data which is required, which is called well deviation. So we know like when you want to, let me give you an example here. Sorry. We know, for example, when you have, when have I'm getting a message like my voice is not clear. Okay, it's clear. Okay, thank you. So just assume you have, you are having a well. Okay, now I think everyone can see this on your screen. You can see there on the screen. Okay, just assume we have drilled a well. Okay. You have a well. So let's assume this is a well. So for the well deviation data, like this is the surface. Okay, this is the surface. Okay, so we are not sure, like it's not clear every time, like once you drill a well vertically, like it will be straight from the coordinate which you have put here on the top. So we are expecting like our well will be deviating. So when we say well deviation, it means like our well will not be straight from the from top down. Like it will be deviating. It will be having some deviation. Like it will deviate. So the, once we take the coordinate here, will be changing. Will be changing from top because it will not be straight. So those kind of deviation are also part of the data which are required when you are building a 3D geological model. So also it's one of the data which is required when you are when you build a 3D geological model. So just take an example. So after this one, also we are going to have well deviation data. We are going to see the way it is. Also, after having well deviation data, we need to have something called well logs. I think every one of you knows about well logs. We physical parameters which are being taken from the well. Some of the well logs are like porosity logs, maybe there is SP spontaneous log, there is resistivity logs, different kind of logs. Also, those are the required data you need to have before building our 3D geological model or static model. But the importance of having these well logs, we are having those logs from wells, from everywhere we're going to have those kind of logs. But we know, just let me show you this example. We now have, maybe we have something. Okay. So I'll be sharing my screen every time. So now I'm sharing. Okay. So just an example. Let's take this is the ground. And then we're having one well here. Also, we have another well here. So, but the difference, the distance from one well to another, from one well, like from this well to this well, maybe it's more than maybe, let's say, maybe it is 40. Okay. Okay, there's some voice. Okay, we have a lot of like distance from one. Okay, you can see here. So just assume like the distance from one well to another well is 40 kilometers. So once we have those well logs data, let's assume now we have like porosity, maybe we have the resistivity logs. We have porosity logs, like we have the for the porosity. We just have the logs for porosity. From this well, from just this one well. And then we have another porosity logs to the second well, well number B, well number A. Maybe let's name this one is A. This is A. Okay. Well. Well, one, A. So this is well 1A, and for this one, let's call it as well 2B. Okay. It's okay. So we have 40 kilometers from one well to another well. So we have petrophysical parameters for like porosity from this well. And then we have another petrophysical parameter from the second well, maybe this one. So we may have different kind of wells. We have wells from here, and we have another wells from here. Petrophysical parameters, maybe porosity for this well one. And for well B, we have another petrophysical parameter. But in our software, we are going to simulate, or we are going to estimate like the parameters for petrophysical parameters, for example, for porosity. We are going to simulate, like we need to have porosity in all this area, like from the subsurface. What will be the porosity in this area where we don't have wells? So this is our function. Like we want now to estimate or to do some probabilistic in order to know, like in this area, within from one well to another well, like from well one to well 2B, how much do we have in terms of porosity? here in between where we don't have any well. So the software automatically is going to distribute the properties from well one to well B. So in between here, we're going now to do something called a geostatistic modeling. A geostatistic modeling, like we're going to do spatial distribution of properties from first well to the second well. So this will be one of the function. This will be one of the function of our software. So we are going to have only parameters for these wells, but what we are going to estimate here in between, now we are going to learn different kind of simulation in order to distribute the property from one well to the second well. So this is our function, and this is will be our task as petroleum expertise when we want to build a static reservoir model. So this will be our function, this will be our work. So we first need also to have some knowledge about spatial distribution. We need also to know the different methods which are going to be used in order to distribute this property from first well, like from first well to the last well, from the first well to this well. So we need to do a lot of trial and different scenarios in order to estimate the properties, porosity property or permeability properties from the first well to the second well. And why are we doing this? We are doing this in order because we first want to know like if there is a connection, there is a continuation of the property from one well to another well. So geologists in the exploration stage, they have done maybe their studies via looking the outcrops or via seismic. So now it's our work now, you as a petroleum expertise, to build a static model using those few information you have from two wells, now to extrapolate, like to know, to distribute the properties from one well to the second well, so into there. And one of the function of this, we are going to minimize the cost. So in order to know the information here, in between here, so if we would have the, like we would have known this kind of technology of building a reservoir model, maybe we would have proposed to the company, let us drill another well here in order to know the information here. But by using just a software, you can now know the distribution of the property from one well to another well. But we are not going only to distribute this information, these properties, without having the crucial understanding about our geology of the area. So that's why you need to have a lot of information before building the static reservoir model. So you need to have a lot of information from different disciplines, maybe from petrophysical, from those guys who did seismic. So all of this will give you the information like in between here, even when I'm going to learn a geospatial simulation, maybe using Kriging or stochastic methods, I will estimate the value of the property in between where there is no well. So also it will reduce the costing. So instead of drilling another well here, we just use the software to estimate or to calculate the amount of the variation of porosity properties or the properties, the petrophysical properties in between where in the area where there is no well. So this is one of the very huge function of using these softwares. So apart from that, we are also apart from well header, well deviation, and well log. So all these three terms, well header, well deviation, and well logs, all this, they fall in the data type, which is called well data. So when I say well data, I mean well header, well deviation, and well logs. So those are the data which are within, which we can find them in the well. So that's why we call them well data. So these are the most important data you need to have before beginning building your static reservoir model. So the format, on the format, we are going to see when we start importing those kind of data. So also there is another kind of data apart from this well data, which is well deviation and well logs. There are other kind of data. We call them well tops, well top, or layered, well tops or layer. So well, for well top, it means when doing drilling, when people are like, when expertise they are drilling, like in every stage, when we encounter a new formation or a new lithology, we usually record that kind of surface. So that's why you can see in my data here, we have surface. For example, here we have the coordinate. We have the coordinate of this well, and then we are going to have the depth at which we encountered this kind of surface. And here we have the name of the well. So for example, for this well, which is called X21-23, we encountered a surface which is called, we just given a name, which is called C818. At this kind of surface were encountered at this depth. We have negative because it is depth. We are going down to the subsurface. So it is on the depth of negative 716. So we encountered this kind of surface. And then in the same well, at this depth, we encountered another surface, which is C8121. Again, in the same well, X21-23, we encountered another surface, which is C8122 at this depth. So the more we go to the depth, we encounter different kind of surface. So this kind of surface also we have recorded also their location, like this is XY. We have recorded the location. But let me take you to another scenario. For this kind of well, maybe this is X2123, this is another one. We have encountered this surface, C81, which is the same like this one. If you can see here, like in this well, this is another well, we have an X2123, and we have X24. We have encountered this kind of surface at this kind of the same surface we have encountered, but it was in this depth. So you can see here the depth is different. So we have like X21-24, this well, we're having the same surface, but they are encountered into different depth. So for example, also, so here we just have I will just give you an example of the two wells. So we have this well and this well, but also in this well, X21-24, we have this kind of surface, which is resembled to this one, but for it was encountered to different depth. So what does this mean? When you are going to build your model, it means the depth will matter. You are going to see like this kind of strata or this kind of layer will be having some slight difference. They will not be in the same level. They will be into different level. So this is one of the data which is mostly required when you want to build a static reservoir model. So now, from there, let's now do a little bit practice. I'll just show you the data we have here. So this is just my file, which is on my desk, like it's on my drive. So well header data is like this. We are having this kind of well head data. Okay. Sorry. Okay. Well header data. It is like this. I don't know if everyone can see this very clear on your phone. Here is our data, the one we're going to use. So, okay, I'll show that to you on your screen. So this is the type of data we are having. Like, we are having different kind of data. You can see this is well header data. We have a well which stands for the well name. We have different kind of wells here. We have 4, 1, 3, 2, 13, 2. We have a well symbol. In our example there, I didn't show you this column, but you need to have well symbol. Well symbol is just to show you, for example, for this well, when it have this kind of symbol, it means it's a production well or injection well, or it's an abandoned well. So well symbol, it stands for the type of well, the way it is, or it's oil well, or it's gas well. So that's the function of well symbol. Also, we have X and Y. These are the coordinates as I've explained. We have kelp bush for the elevation. Also, we have measured depths. So this is one of the type of data you may have. So it must not be like the way it was I showed you to the first example, but also you can have the well header in this format. You may have a well name. It's supposed to have well name. Symbol, some of them, they don't put symbol, but most this is very important for more clarification in order to know that this is which kind of well do we have. Also, you need to have coordinates, KB, kelp bush, and the measured depths. So this is just an example of the well data you have. So now let's see how we can import our data into our program. So we are going now to open our program. So this is Petrel. Okay. I think everyone you can see there. This is our Petrel 2009. From here, from our Petrel, on top here, we are having like the project name. If you have saved your data, or if you have saved your project, the name of your project will be there. Also, we have this panel, which shows you how to open the new project. even if you have another project, you have opened this one, you can open the project from here. We have this, we have the menu bar, like it shows you the files, edit, file, insert, project tools, window, and help. Also, from here, you have something like this one, like there is a toolbar here of different tools. So we will see the use of all this when we start importing some information. So here is just a 3D window, which will, once you import your information, once you import your data, you can be able to see what is in 3D visualization. So you can maximize from here. And then here in this part, we have an input panel where you can start to import your data. But first we need to know like the type of data and the data format, how are we going to import those kind of data. So now, for example, as I've said before, let me go back and show you something. From our PPT here. Okay. We said well header, its format in Petrel, its format is supposed to be well header bracket star dot bracket dot bracket. So this is the format when you want to import well header. So how are we going to import the well header? Now let's see. We need to go direct to our, let's go to our software, and then you will go to this panel, to the input panel. You have to right click. Once you right click, something like this one will occur. There will be an import on trees, and there will be an insert folder in trees. So now for us, we are just going to import on tree. You click there, and then we are going to search like the place where we can find our data. And I've said like we have our data in our desktop. We have first in our desktop, so it's on this folder. Then for the file type, then now we have to go and look for the file format, the one we saw there. We said we are going to import web header, so we are going to look our format, like we are going to take here. We have web header, like this will be the format for our web header. Like our format of our web header is supposed to be in this format. So once we click here, you can be able now to find out our data, like the way it is. So here is our file, web header. Then now we need to double click. Okay, just select, double click. So, and wait for the software to respond. Okay. So now there will be a dialog box like this one, and you need now to check down here. You're able to see your data type, like the way it is here. Can you see? So we are now going to select to see the way our file, our data, the format of our data, the way they are. So now let's now don't see if someone can you see. Okay. don't know if you can see the message box from the is then and see the you can see can you be able to see the format? Okay, now here we have our in this dialog box. Okay, I can see people are responding. They're saying they don't see anything. Okay, so I'm going to take a snapshot of this one. Okay. Okay, I'm sorry. So we are going to I will share to you the screen. Here is what is going to be what I'm seeing here. So I think most of you don't see. So once you import this kind of data, you now see like there is a well name. Okay. Like here in a column. It's supposed to match with what is on our row, our column here. So if this is our data, like in the first column, we have a well name. So here we have to put name. So in the second column, we have X coordinates. So here in our second column, it's supposed to be X coordinates. So because my screen shot is not like my screen view. When I show you my screen, it's not responding. So I don't know how we're going to do, but I think I will send you something and you see. So here in the second column, also it's supposed to resemble with our data type. So for the third column, also it's supposed to resemble our data type. So if in our data, our third column is for Y coordinate, also in this data is supposed to be like that. So if also KB is on the fourth column, also here in our fourth column is supposed to resemble what is in our data. So that's what I'm doing now here. So you can't see, but after I finish, I think you will be able to see what is happening. So just second column is X, third column is Y, fourth column is KB, and fifth column is top depth. Okay, is top depth or MD? I think I'm trying to see here. No one can see what is happening in our screen here. Does it respond? So I don't know. Nothing is responding from the screen there. So I think I will find a way on how you can be able to see this one. But for today, okay, a lot of parameters you need to see them. So I don't know what can I. Okay, I finished. Imported my data, but the most important things you need to find out about the procedure. You need to see the procedure. So I've already imported all my wells here, but you are supposed to see the procedure. But I don't know when I light click, and like the message box doesn't show on your screen there. So I don't know, but for me, I can see it here. Maybe it's a technical problem. But I think tomorrow we have to resolve this issue. We have to resolve this issue. So we are very sorry for what is happening, because even for me, I can't see, and the procedure need to know to see what is on the message box, because there is where I'm trying to configure all the information. But in my screen is there, but on your screen, I can't see anything. So we are very sorry for that. I think tomorrow we need to fix this issue. So those, it was just a procedure on how to import, and to import the wells from beginning to the end. And like here now, you can even change the well header, because yeah, so you can't see like what I'm doing now, but I'm trying to change the symbols. You can change the symbols. The way you can see there, you just see something is. So I'm trying to configure some of the informations, but you can't see. So this is our wells, the one we have imported. Here we just imported the well header. The well header. That's why you can see even the well, our wells are very straight, like from the beginning to the end, they are very straight. So they are very straight. When you see these wells are very straight, but in the sense, it's impossible. It's not possible if you can have this kind of well which is very straight from the bottom to the top. So there will be some deviations. So what we import the well deviation data, we can see even this well will be deviating. So you can see some meandering on the well. But for now, we just see the straight well from the bottom to the, from the top to the bottom. So because we just imported the well header, we don't have the well deviation data. So this is just a demonstration of today's class on how to be doing, how to import, how to prepare, and how to import this kind of data to our software. So I think due to time, we have used 1 hour. So I'll just ask our moderator to help us on the issue in order to everyone to be able to see what I'm demonstrating from my screen, because I'm just receiving some messages from you guys, like you don't see anything. So today's class was about data types of creating the reservoir model. I've shown you. Also, there are some data preparation. So we have already made prepared data. So, but when you want to prepare this kind of data, you really need to know about the format of it. So the format I've shown you for the well header, for the well creation, and for the tops, they are supposed to match like that. So if you have different kind of data which are not in this, that kind of format, you can even create a format for yourself. You can format them in your according to the format which is required, because those are the parameters which are required. So software installation, which is mostly one of the tasks of today's class, for it, I'm very sorry guys, I didn't send you the link, but after this class, I will send the link about how to install the software and how to download the software from my website, because there was a mistake we made yesterday. So I'm very sorry, I will just send you today. And then data input, this was the task of today. So we have done it. We have seen the way to input those kind of data like the well header. So we are supposed to import a lot of data, but due to time, we just have 1 hour every day. And our workshop was just to give you the green light on how you can do or you can create a leading geological model. So it's just a way to to be doing all this stuff. So for more information or for more details, we are conducting a lot of our online classes in our platform, which is called Petroleum Software Online Training. You can just communicate with us and then we can enroll you to our course, which takes 14 days consecutive. If you will take 14 days consecutive, you can be able to create this 3D geological model from the beginning to the end. But for our session here, we are just giving you an overview on how to create this 3D geological model from static model. So guys, due to time, and because I'm just showing you now for this class, for those who are interested, guys, I'll just send you my phone number. It's there in my WhatsApp. Also, you can contact SkolarGate, and then we'll be having those class from how to create a 3D geological model to the end, from the beginning to the end. So this is just an overview for you guys. You can understand how to do the 3D geological model, but I'm providing for you a free software. It is very free. You can just download from our site. You can do your practice, but for detail and for a lot of practice on how to get different kind of models using different data, please, we'll give you a chance to join our online class, which is on our platform. So you can just go to our social media. We are in Facebook and Instagram. Just search for Petroleum Software Online Training. But also contact, please kindly contact our coordinator here. Just contact them, SkolarGate, for more information about this course of Petroleum Software Online Training. So thank you for today. Tomorrow's task will be about well correlation, well and well log, mixed surface, well tops, and structural modeling. Though it will be a very big task, so I will be able to continue how to import some of the data once we solve this problem of showing you the message box. And then we will show you how to create the surface and to do some tasks like well correlation. So thank you very much, guys. For those who have questions, please, you can turn on your mic and then you can ask any question you want to ask from me. You are all welcome. Mr. Moderator, please, it's your turn. Thank you very much.